to get together. When I used to be able to talk to my grandmother, and I would ask her, how are you doing? Everybody is in table order. In other words, when we get to heaven, you can't do nothing till I get there.
All right.
But when I get there, sit around the Lord's table. Everybody. Come on, church. Everybody.
Thank God for you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, yes.
wasn't you, wouldn't be no us.
Amen.
We're in this thing together.
That's right, that's right. Amen.
There's a word.
Yes.
Lily.
All right.
Yes, it comes from the 16th chapter of the book of Matthew.
All right. All right.
And starting with verse 24 and concluding with verse 26. 24. And it says, then said Jesus,
amen,
unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever shall lose his life for my sake,
that's it. All right.
Shall find it.
Whoa.
For what? For is a man profit if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? For what shall a man give in exchange for his soul?
Come on, that's a question. That's a question.
You may be seated.
All right, that's a good question.
I want to preach today with your help. Your prayers,
yes, sir,
and your witnesses,
yes, sir,
from this subject. Giving up is hard to do.
Right.
Marcus, giving up is hard to do.
All right.
Thank you, ushers.
All right. Yeah.
Whether or not you agree with me,
all right,
the truth is still the truth.
Yes.
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 And I want to say this unequivocally, that we as children of God,
all right,
are being torn between the world and the Word of God.
Yes.
In fact, the reality of the situation, there is a war going on between Maryland, the spirit, and the flesh.
Yes.
Good and evil.
Yes.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Yes.
And I believe, church, that the reason we are engaged in this kind of struggle is because our inability to want to deny self.
All right. All right.
One of the reasons that it's hard to give up on self is because self has a way of manifesting itself through our emotions, our attitude, and our activity.
Yes. All right.
Yes. It seems like every time we turn around, we find ourselves wrestling from one dimension to another dimension. And James, as we struggle to determine who we are, and who is in charge.
All right.
It is difficult to receive what God has for us when we are struggling with so much baggage that keep getting in our way.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Tell your neighbor, neighbor, let it go.
Let it go.
We need to forget those things that are behind us. For I press toward the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. Church, this is 2017. Some stuff has happened that we need to let go. Look at our text, Savannah.
All right.
The Bible says, Jesus turned and said to his disciples, if any man want to come after me, the first thing he have to do is deny self. Now, if we would be truthful, Mitchell, for about 5 seconds, we would have to admit that deny self is a hard thing to do. The reason, Marcus, I say that is because most of us were in love with self before we ever met Jesus. I tell you, giving up is hard to do. It's hard to engage in self-denial. The reason, Albert, I make this assertion is because self has some information on us. It is all true. The first thing that self make you believe is I am what I have. And what I have is what makes me somebody. Or somebody missed that. I said what I have makes me somebody. And when I don't have it, I am nothing. Let me break it down for you. The world want me to believe that I'm nothing unless I got something. But I want the world to know as long as I got Jesus. I said as long as I got Jesus, I got enough. So I did him. I said as long as I got Jesus, I can make it. Clear. I'm not against folks having stuff. It's all right to get stuck. Brother Nate, as long as you don't let stuff get you. You need to quit trying to impress people with stuff. I'm talking about people that you don't even like. Remember this. Somebody had it before you. And somebody will have it after you. For the Bible tells them, the Lord said, you fool, this night your soul is required of you. And who will have that stuff? What does it profit A man can gain the whole world and lose his soul. Then there are some folk who believe that I am what I do. You believe that what you do, your job, your vocation, your profession makes you important and elevates you above other folk. But the law of physics say, whatever goes up, self will make you do anything to stay on top of your game. Self will also keep you focused on stuff you can fix up. As long as you can fix it, it's good enough. Self will have you thinking you can hide the mess on the inside. Sometimes the folks who look the best are still messed up on the inside. They're just good at covering it up. They will smile in your face as long as you tell them how good they look. But a smile is nothing but a frown turned upside down. Somebody ought to make some noise in here. Jesus said, if any man want to follow me, you must not, you should, you must deny self. That is a command. Stop spending your life on you. Your focus in life is not to be better than anyone else, but to be better than you used to be. You don't have to try to be better than me. Just keep on improving yourself. Now, if you want to get rid of self, don't let your focus on self keep you from focusing on Jesus. If you're going to engage in self-denial and break free of self, you got to surrender by staying in touch with Jesus. Because if you don't fill your mind with Jesus, you will fill it with self. As a man thinketh, so is he. Notice what Jesus said. He said, follow me. And follow me does not mean walk. Follow me means obey. That person must deny self, take up his cross, and follow him daily. Not once in a while, but daily. 24/7. 365 days a year. You must follow him. And when Jesus talked about losing your life, he's not talking about losing your life per se. He's talking about focusing on your outcome and what's going to happen to you. In other words, stop worrying about tomorrow. Hear me now. Stop worrying about tomorrow. Look at the sparrow. The sparrow don't work. The sparrow don't have a refrigerator. The sparrow don't cook. But he never goes hungry. I've never seen a bird fall out of the sky dying from starvation. God got a worm for every bird. And if he takes care of a sparrow, I know. I said, I know. I know. He will take care of me. His eyes are on the sparrow. So I know without a doubt he watches over me. And if I lose my life bread for him, I will find more than life. I will find life and life more abundantly. Not because I'm a preacher or what I possess, but because I am a child of the kingdom. know how you feel about it. But Jesus know me. And I know him. And I know what he can do. And I believe if I fall to him, I will have more than enough.
He'll fix it.
in your life.
Yes, he will.
Yeah.
I know it's hard to give up on self.
All right.
But if you surrender your life,
yes, sir,
all to Jesus, I can surrender.
Yeah.
All to Jesus, I give. If you surrender your life, church, I don't care what folks think about you. How much they talk about you. They tell you never be nothing. That's your opinion. God told me to make no joke. God told me, Kettleman, come over here.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Tell me that I'm a different person.
Because
I turned my life over to Jesus. I turned my life. Yeah, it is the best thing I have done. I tried a lot of things. But Nate, I found out. He's the best thing that ever happened. He's the best thing. How many of you know he's the best thing? Tell your neighbor, neighbor, he's the best thing that ever happened to me. I know, Granny, I don't have to guess. Nobody don't have to tell me, Greg. I know where I would be. Hell now, with some Vaseline drawers on. Oh yeah. Oh yes, I would. But he's a good God. He's glad to snatch me up. Don't let folks tell you what you're gonna be. Tell them, Lord, I got God on my side. I can accomplish any and everything. All of us got a past. Huh? I said all of us have messed up. Every saint got a future.